just breathe. It is not only okay, it is more than right and just and correct. Dare I say, it might even be necessary for us as individuals to take a few moments a day to stop everything. Stop our thoughts. Stop our feelings. Stop our fears and projections of the future. Stop our antagonizing and worrying over the past. Stop our movement. Even briefly, stop our breathing so that we can find ourselves at the deepest seat of ourself. And then just breathe. Find this center, this throne, this seat of your phenomena, of your perception. Let go of everything else and just breathe. From this place, you may forgive yourself and forgive all others as your meditation. And perhaps, organically, naturally, achieve a catharsis and healing for yourself. It is a practice, a living practice, so you must practice it. And the first thing is to abandon all expectation. Abandon all overanalyzing and overthinking and over-rationalizing whether or not what you are trying to do makes sense, and just genuinely be. This curiously takes radical acceptance. But it starts with just breathing. For those minds that can't help but ask the question, why just breathe? What does that mean? How does that help? Don't tell me to just breathe. Stop and breathe and remember, as your emotions change, so does your breath. Is this not true? Is this not so? Is this not organic and real? If you're normal and you're commuting to work and you merely get caught up in an accident that's happening in front of you, you suddenly go through a really wide range of generally negative emotions and your breathing radically changes. Insert any example of an emotional shift. You're feeling upbeat and then you get some bad news. You're feeling kind of glum and then something energizes you. What's the first most primal thing you experience? A shift, a radical shift in your breath. Its depth, its rhythm, its intensity. Would it not be natural and organic and true for your breath to work exactly the same way but inverse? If you are feeling sad or down or upset about something and you consciously choose your breath instead of let it be an expression and a retention and an attachment and an expression of that self-abusive, vicious cycle of our thinking about our emotions, thinking about our emotions, change your breath. Stop what you're doing. Find your center of being and just breathe. Tune in for more. And if you're new, don't worry. I know it looks like there's not a lot of shows, but there's like there used to be or something. I pulled them all down, and I'm going to do a little bit of reworking stuff and put a bunch of sort of throwback Thursday kind of episodes featuring the best and the least rambly and distracted parts so as to keep things clear and simple. And, yeah, if you're just walking into this podcast, be sure to also check out should it interest you. If you hate it, come over and listen. Maybe your hate will at least be less hatey. But check out my tarot journal and cartomancy readings radio hour podcast journal show extravaganza. All my stuff ends with extravaganza, should you be wondering. Go and find your breath today, my friends. And if you find yourself too busy to make that time today,